Because there is something wrong. Why I don't know. Maybe the operator forgets to set something.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, that happens all the time when you're doing with technology, things go wrong. Yeah, but you just have to adapt.
Yeah. It's cloudy here. What about there?
It's snowing.
Oh.
Yeah, a lot of snow.
Nice. Okay, wait, still 15, 16. Okay.
All right.
It is around 40 participants. Nice to know you, Dian Indriani.
Hey, Dian. Okay, nice to know you too.
Okay, hi, Budian. Okay, good.
Okay.
Okay.
Shall
wait,
I continue?
Still 20 participants. Wait, still 20, 21. Okay.
Yes.
I don't want to miss some explanation.
Yeah.
It must be more complete. This is the second time I have live. The previous is from Canada and from France.
Okay.
Two weeks ago.
Okay.
And yeah, it was running well. But now, yeah, because there is something, it doesn't matter. That's common for...
Happens all the time in the internet. Yes, the people in Finland are wearing masks. Okay, shall I continue?
Yes. Okay, thank you.
Okay.
So sorry. Yeah.
No problem. Okay, so 5 minutes left. I will. Let's see where I was. Yes. Oh, I have to share my screen.
Yes.
Can you enable the screen sharing, Ida?
The operator screen sharing, Fajar. Okay, Pak Fajar, are you ready for screen sharing?
Yes, now it works. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So let's continue about the challenges, adaptation, and learning. So what I left where the government said that, okay, go to online school, and that's basically it. Then it is up to for the school schools to decide, okay, how are we going to do this? There was a lot of differences in ICT, so computer skills and school resources. Some schools already had done a lot of work with computers. They had invested in them. Some hadn't, so they were in problems. There was a lot of like teaching challenges, especially in artistic and practical subjects. How can I teach, for example, sports, online sports? Okay, what is that? We play esports, Fortnite or something. so there was a lot of challenges there, and how to support those with less computer skills, like teachers who hadn't got the skills and the children. That was a big challenge, because especially for the small children, some knew how to use online platforms, some didn't. So that was a big challenge. But still, it was with a lot of teacher cooperation and through social media, teachers got together and tried to figure out, okay, how can we do this? And all the Finnish teachers formed up networks in social media and shared, okay, this work, this doesn't work. And it was constant learning for the teachers also. But they tried to carry on as normal as possible. Same curriculum with familiar starting time, breaks, and etc. And Boop, this was very great. Boop publishers gave up their digital material for free for a moment. So schools who hadn't bought the digital material could use it for free. But it was still very heavy workload. Many teachers went to the night working with stuff, a lot of preparation, and also for the parents working from home, because you don't have a break for children. You try to work and your children has problems. So it was a big workload.
And then 14th,
schools reopened, but still many meetings have stayed online. And the new wave of pandemic has occasionally forced some schools moved back online. But everything is now easier because it's already familiar. And there's a recommendation for school employees to wear masks. In Finland, everything is a recommendation. It is very hard for especially Nordic countries to force that you have to use a mask. It's always a recommendation. You could use a mask. And for the future, the provider of education decides how it will be done regarding the situation. And in case of infection, a 10-day quarantine for those potentially infected in the class. And there are recommendations for heightened hygiene and reduced group activities. So this is basically what happened during the pandemic, where the pandemic is still going, but not so, the schools are now open, and occasionally if a student gets infected or a teacher, then they have to move to online.
Okay. Lauri, thank you so much.
Thank you, Ida.
Thank you so much for your brief explanation today. I think it's quite clear, some of your slides here, but I'm sure that many participants wants to know more about the explanation, or maybe there is something related to the explanation you don't understand. I open one session, the first session, for three questions first. Okay, so please raise your hand in the chat. Raise your hand. You can make question for three participants only. Then before you make question, please mention your name and your origin. So please, I open the discussion today, question and answer, please. Raise your hand, Bapak Ibu. It's not only me who has to talk, so I just moderator here, so you can ask everything. Okay. Mm-hmm. Bapak Ibu, come on. While we are waiting for questions, you may raise your hand. Yeah, please raise your hand here. Okay, wait. There is one that I don't understand here. Matriculation examination, you have mentioned that.
Yes.
What kind of matriculation examination here? While we are waiting for other questions, yeah, this is my private questions.
Yes.
You may explain.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yes, it's a hard name for pretty simple thing. So after high school, you go to this. This is one of the few only nationwide tests in Finland. But in matriculation exam, you pick five subjects where you make a big test, like you read many months, where you show all your expertise in those subjects. And with the matriculation examination, it's like a big test, a really important test, because with that test you apply to university. So that after high school you take the test, and with that test you go to the university.
Okay, what kind of subject that is that are in matriculation examination? What are the subjects?
There are most of the basic subjects. For example, I put in test English, Swedish, and mathematics, history, and let me think. And a Finnish language. But there are, you can also pick many other physics, chemistry. It depends where, in what university you want to go, then you pick what you want to do.
Oh, okay. There is a question from Muhammad Sari.
Okay.
You can, Muhammad Sari first. Muhammad Sari, okay. Which one is Muhammad Sari? Yeah? You may raise your hands, say hello in the slide, and then you can unmute the speaker. Muhammad Sari. Okay, come on. Who is Muhammad Sari? Okay, come on.
Okay,
you may introduce yourself and then origin or hey. What institution you are from.
Okay, hello everyone. Hello, thank you for sharing so much precious knowledge. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
I would like to introduce myself. My name is Muhammad Sari. I'm from Lamongan, East Java, Indonesia. I'm an English teacher. So my question for you is, what do you think is the biggest challenge for teachers there in Finland regarding with this pandemic? And what?
No,
sorry.
No problem.
And there is a voice. There is a sound. Okay. And what did the government do for teachers regarding with the challenges during this pandemic? Thank you, Mr. Lowry.
Okay.
What the government
do, yeah? Yes, good
okay,
question. So
I save the questions first. And the second question is from Buyatinia. Buyati Husnia from Gresik. Come on. And Buyati Husnia, this one. Okay. Unmute your microphone, please. Thank you. We can hear you.
No, I cannot hear you.
We cannot hear your voice, Buyati. We can hear your voice, Buyati. Okay, wait. We can hear your voice. Your voice. Buyati. Your speaker, maybe.
If you have maybe the wrong microphone set in the Zoom settings, but you can type in the chat if it doesn't work the microphone.
Okay. Puyati, maybe you can chat here. You can chat here.
Hi, I've changed my microphone.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, speak loudly, please.
Can you hear my voice, Mr. Lowry?
Yeah, okay. Now I hear you.
Thank you for the chance that given to me.
Uh-huh.
I would like assessment. In your presentation, you say that there is no competition among students in Finland, and how we can measure our capability of our students if there is no competition or less, or there is no homework, there is homework, but it is not too much homework for our students. So how can we measure the effectiveness or the comprehensive of our students in learning our material?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Puyati. Another question? Yeah. Pak Erlu, do you have any questions? Okay. Unmute your microphone, please.
Yeah. I have a bit out of our topic. Is it okay?
Speak slowly because it is unclear.
Okay. Yeah, I have a question, okay. But it's a bit out of from the topic.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Is it okay, Bu Ida?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you for the chance. Hello, Mr. Lowry. My name is Erlu, and I would like to ask you a question about, is it proper if the government increase the teacher's income in order to make the education quality better?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay.
And the last question, is the teacher's income of Finland teacher high?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, good questions. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, very good. Thank you so much, Pak Erlu, ya. Okay,
welcome.
Vera, thank you so much. So it's time, Laura, for answering the questions. The first is from Muhammad Sari Lamongan. The first question is the biggest challenge in pandemic for teachers, and the second one's what has the government done to in education during pandemic?
Mm. Okay. Well, the biggest challenge of was how to make it actually work. how to give effective teaching online. That was the biggest practical question, because there was no guidelines, like no one told, there was no information bank where every teacher could go, okay, this is how I transform my class online. The practical transferring the school online, that was the biggest challenge. And in especially it was hard, like, how can I activate children? Like, because in some children, they did really well online. They did, you give instructions, they do. But some, it is very easy to disappear in online. You just put away your screen and you don't know. You try to call the child, no one answers. So that was a big challenge, and we gave a lot of workload for teachers. Like, teachers worked far more longer than they used to. So that was the biggest challenge for sure. And what did the government do? Well, that's how the Finnish government operates in education. Government says, do this and figure it out by yourself how you do it. That was basically, government didn't take a lot of government told what to do, go online, and that was almost basically it. No, not more. they give you the freedom, but they also don't tell you how to do it. You just, they give you the mission, figure out how to teach online, and then government says, okay, our job here is done, you figure it out yourself. So that was basically what Finnish government told. It made the exception law that you can give teaching this way. And after that, it was all for the teachers to actually figure it out. I hope I answered your question.
Okay, Muhammad Sari, is it clear enough to answer the questions? Do you have any comments?
Yes, that's clear enough. And can I ask one more question, please? Okay. I just want to know what time is it there in Finland now, Mr. Lauri?
In Finland, it's 12 o'clock at the moment.
12 o'clock?
Yeah, 12 o'clock.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lauri.
Okay, the next question is from Buyati Gresik. How measure the students' capability without competition?
Yes. Yeah, that is a very, very important question. And I have to say that, of course, there is some competition. It is very, very minimal, but you don't have to give grades until the children are 11 years old. Before 11 years, you don't have to give them grades. In Finland, we talk about formative assessment, which is constantly the teacher monitors how the child is doing in his or her learning during the days, every day checking out how are you doing, okay, where are you now? So it is constant observation. And this is only possible with small group sizes. If you have 50 children, it is really hard for the teacher to keep, this is Jack there, this is Tara there, where he's going. So it is own requirement, the small group size. So you can all the time know where someone is going. After the year, children are given grades, but it is not emphasized like who gets what. Of course, children compare it a little bit, but in many countries, there is much more emphasis. Okay, she is the best in class, he is the worst in class, and it is kept to minimum, like as little competition, as little grades as possible. It is more focused on the process, like teacher all the time monitors how are you doing, what are your goals, where do you want to go, here is where you need to improve. And it's during the process, the assessment, because when the teacher observes clearly every day where someone is, then she also knows, okay, now I have a clear picture how good he or she is at this subject and what he or she needs to improve. So it's constant observation, but it's not, they don't compare, okay, you're a little bit better than her. Or it is very, very individual, and all the goals are very individual. So there is not like every child has to reach this. No. It is, what are your goals? And here you are good. Here you need improvement. And it is for you individually. So it is very individual teaching, and also learning about the individual student. But it is very hard. I know it is extremely hard with large group sizes. It is totally different then.
Yeah, like that, Buyati. So why there is no competition? This is the way how we grade the students, because the size of the class are very limited, only 20 students, compared with Indonesian students 30, 40 in one class. Yes. It's rather difficult to apply here, yeah?
Yes, when I was in Indonesia, I went a few days in an Indonesian school, and there was like 40 children, and I thought, okay, I would have to teach in a totally different way here. So it's different.
Oh, okay. So you have been in Indonesian schools?
Yes, only a few days. I really didn't teach much. It was more like going around, but I cannot say I would be teaching much, but I saw the classrooms, met some children, and I saw, okay, this is very different reality compared to ours.
Yeah, that's correct. I think that Wilma also has told you about this.
Yes.
Is it clear enough to answer your questions?
May I say something to Mr. Lowry?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
May I say something to Mr. Lowry?
Can you hear? Yeah.
Can you hear my voice, Mr. Lowry?
Yes. I put more volume here.
Yes.
I mean that there is a big difference in education system between my country and your country, because if we see in our syllabi, there is assessment and there is evaluation in every single of class. Although they are still in elementary school, junior or senior high school, there is assessment. So the difference about our systems, our education system, it is about evaluation, about assessment. So the teacher in our, many teacher or maybe most of teacher in Indonesia do not have a freedom to create a class, do not how to evaluate our student by ourselves, because there is
standard from the government. There is
some decisions for our government. So
yes.
Well, how do you think about that? So should we do the government ask, or we have to make creativity to our student itself? Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Yes. It is very different. And of course, there is some criteria, like how to do assessment evaluation in Finland, but it is much more freedom for the teacher compared to many countries, because there is respect for the teacher, for the teacher's knowledge to how to evaluate the students. So there, and it is done more towards learning than towards grades, because there are two types. You can evaluate for the grades and you can evaluate for better learning. There's a little bit difference there.
Okay, thank you. I think that's enough, Wiyatia. Okay, the next question is from Pak Erlu. Pak Erlu asks, is it proper if the government increase income for teacher to make better education? And okay. Is it high for teacher salary over there in Finland?
All right.
Compared with...
I think... With some, if the teacher, I think teachers need good enough salary so that they are not, or that it compensates for their knowledge and work. That is important, because if you are in an important role, and especially in a position like a teacher or policeman or so, things like that, you need a good salary, because then you are not so tempted for like corruption and bribing and stuff like that. That is very, very important. So in some cases, giving more income to teachers might actually increase the better education, but not, it is not the only way. It might give some benefit, but it needs also, It is not linear, like if you give more money, you get better teaching, but it can, to a certain point, it can of course be useful, because when the teacher get enough salary, the teacher well-being is good, and the teacher that is healthy, feels good, will also give better teaching. In Finland, the teacher's salaries Well, of course, every teacher says it's too low, but I don't know if there is a profession in the world that says we have enough salary. Everyone thinks their salary is low, but I think Finnish teacher salary is very good. It's like middle class, upper middle class salary. So it's for me, it's perfectly fine, and I wouldn't need any addition. Some teachers say they would like more, but compared to many other countries, I think Finnish teacher salary is very good, because in some countries it's much less, and which I think is a problem compared to the stress and engagement you need to have when you're a teacher.
Okay,
thank you, sir. Mr. Lauri. Yeah, because why do I ask about that? I see that some of the problems of Indonesia education is from, I'm so sorry, from the teacher. I mean the performance of the teacher.
Okay, yes.
Yes. Thank you.
That makes sense.
Okay, thank you so much. The operator announced again there is something wrong. He said that he has set the time until 2 hours, but it is reminded by the by the Zoom that we still have 8 minutes more. So I do hope we can continue for the new link later. Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know. The operator said it has been set as usual, but why there is something wrong related to the connection. Okay. The first session I have open, and the next session I open 3 questions again. So please, you may chat here first before you ask. I open 3 questions, dear all participants. While we are waiting for questions, this is that I want to ask. Liberal adult education.
Okay, now can you say again, there was a connection problem.
Okay, liberal adult education.
Mm-hmm. You want what to know is what that? Is, okay, yes.
Oh.
Liberal adult.
Barry wants to ask, wait, there are. Okay, continue.
Yes, liberal art education is a government-supported education for adults in very many different. It's like free courses for adults in many different things. You can learn. You can learn art. You can learn mathematics. You can learn language. It's government-supported education courses for adults and very wide range. It's almost free or free. It depends, but there are many. It costs very little because it's government-supported.
So it's like for vocational like that?
Yes.
Okay, vocational school, yeah. Okay, one question. There is question from Johan Nurhidayat. Nurhidayat, please raise your hand. Where are you? You can unmute. You can unmute your speaker, Johan.
Yes.
Okay. Please mention, introduce yourself, your name, and also your institution.
Yes, my name is Johan Hidayat from Sumeneb, Madura.
Oh, okay.
Thank you from Miss Ida Nurmala, who has given me time to give some questions maybe for Mr. Hagman. Good day, Mr. Hagman.
Thank you. Good day.
Yeah. I see and I look from your presentation that of the written that less is more and slow is better. Like the, I think that is better. I read your presentation, Mr. Agno. Perhaps you can give us or give me especially more explanation about it. But as I know that in education, I think it's more is need acceleration. Perhaps like a motorbike racing, maybe who needs a speed. And from football, I think it need acceleration too. And then for in as I know that there are settlement that who come first and he treat first like this. Perhaps you can give me need more explanation about it. Thank you, Mr. Arna.
Okay.
Okay.
The question is about. Sorry. Again.
Yeah.
Is.
Less more. Slow is better.
Mm-hmm.
Settlement
slow
like
is
this.
Better.
Yeah.
Okay. The next question is from Nur Hidayat Alifia. Dava Alifia, ya. Okay. Dava. Dava, please. Dava?
Hello.
Hello. Oh, Dava. Okay, Dava. Thank you. Okay, Dava.
Yeah, my name is Dava. I from Buduran. My question is about the tax. In Finland, there are still online learning, right? It's in Finland, have many tax or homework, or there is no tax or homework? Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. The last question is from Farah. Farah, come on. Farah? Farah, raise your hand.
Okay. Thank you for the opportunity. I just want to ask about, for the first, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Farah Dila from Buduran Sidoarjo. It's Java. Then my questions, what is punishment that the teacher has
given to the student.
Because in Indonesia, what kind of punishment in Finland? Because in Indonesia, the teacher has given punishment, but the student still did that again. So.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much. So sorry for all participants. After this, you have to move into the new link. Sorry, this is inconvenience time, yeah, because maybe this is the first time I get the problem like this. Before, I never have such kind of problem like this. We have to move from one link to another link. We have to move from one link to another link. But this is the technology. I do apologize for inconvenience today. After this, we will move to another link. While we are waiting for the class or the, what's that? The screen end. Lauri can answer the question from Johan Sumenep Madura. Slow is better. Okay.
Okay, Lauri, it says there's less than 1 minute. Let's see how far I can go with this. But it is basically the slow